Welcome back to Caveman Mining, guys. You will notice pretty quiet. On today's video, we're going to be doing a test for the light hash rate unlock for LOLMINER. You guys know on the last video, we tested the GMINER, the auto unlock of 2.68. And yeah, I wasn't thoroughly impressed. We saw a lot of inconsistencies with power consumption and just the wattage spiking up in different scenarios. So I'm hoping LOLMINER is a little bit more stable for power from what I've heard, but yeah, without further ado, let's jump into the miner. Hey guys, so we are now in Hive OS and I just want to take a look at a few things with you guys, but before we jump into the miner and some of the specifications of the config file, we are again covering the LOLMINER 1.32A, okay, and the arguments that we're going to test today is the --- mode space light hash rate 1 and the --- mode light hash rate 2 arguments. So we're going to test that out and see how well things work, and so we'll see what things happen. Just a recap in terms of the drivers, okay? So I am running the driver 4.60.91.03. On the GMINER test, we had issues with the 4.70 and the 4.65 to get the full unlocked hash rates. Actually, the 4.70 didn't work at all. We're gonna leave the drivers as is for this test. What we're gonna just look at is the stock hash rates of this a LOLMINER for the light hash rate 3060 RTX card, and you guys can see we're already running the miner at 26.30, okay? I'm gonna go into Hive Shell to just take a look at things, and we're going to fire up the camera right now to get a live preview of the wattage at the wall, because I think that is another important factor of, you know, really reading this efficiency and making sure things are, you know, the way they're supposed to be. So as you guys can now see in the bottom right hand corner, we have the wattage meter up and we're pulling about 219 to 226 watts, bouncing back and forth a little bit there, but let's take a look at Hive Shell to see what we get. And just looking at kind of the stock settings here, so 26.29 mega hash, power's at 131. Yeah, so let's go over now and try our first argument change. So we're going to go into the miner and we're going to change the argument to --- mode space light hash rate 2, and let's apply that and update for all workers. It's important we hit that button or else it's not going to apply. We should see our Hive Shell session terminate naturally in just a second. There it goes. I'm gonna close that window out. We're gonna close this session out and come back to Hive. And we are looking at already the wall. At the wall, we see definitely a little bump in wattage. So I'm seeing between 247 to 256. That seemed to be either that was a little blip or something happened there. So let's take a look. Maybe that was just the miner spooling up to not have accurate reading there. So let's open shell. And we're hanging around the same wattage, just hanging around the 230 watt mark at the wall. That's okay. Let's see if this light hash rate mode made any difference at all. Very curious on that. So we'll go in and we will do miner. And already we do have a jump in mega hash. That's 32.94 mega hash to 32.80. And sitting at 139 watts, okay? So, yep, in the software, we're actually getting, you know, one reporting, and then at the wall, we're getting a much higher reporting, which there's a pretty big variance. Usually, obviously, we get, you know, higher wattage because of the motherboard and any other the components that are up there, but that's, you know, 139 to 230 watts. I mean, it's almost 100 watt increase. So it's definitely still not 100% like good, I would say, at this point. But Hive is reporting the hash rate there. Let's see if we can go down on the power limit here. Let's do like 125 watts and see if we get a drop in hash rate. See if that makes a difference at all on the wattage meter. That would be an interesting stat to see. So at the wall, we drop down to 213 to 212 watts. And we definitely just want to pay attention to the software as well. So let's see what our hash rate is. Let's see how bad it suffers from where it was. So 32.38 in terms of mega hash, and let's see what the software is reporting for wattage. So definitely slightly better at the wall by bringing that power level down. And let's see, yeah, 32.51 at the pool, 32.35, and 124 on the software. So yeah, not astronomically better. But interesting. Last test here, guys, is we're going to try the other mode for the argument, which is going to be light hash rate 1. And let's see if that makes any difference at all. And we'll see what we can see here. So I think LHR LP is another argument, so maybe we'll take a look at that and see what that does. But let's go back and take a look at the wall. So again, we got that spool up of wattage as soon as we change the miners, and we're back down to 212 watts ish. So let's open the shell. And yeah, I'm very curious to see if we get any enhancements at all. The wattage has not been all that different in terms of the change at the wall. But yeah, I'm seeing if this does anything in terms of hash rate. I mean, I'm not blown away from what I'm seeing so far, but definitely some strides in the right direction. Okay, so definitely a little bit better with the light hash rate 1. Argument in terms of hash rate, just slightly better, 32.56, and the power level is exactly the same. There's nothing changed there. I didn't expect a huge change, and yeah, we're still sitting at the wall, 213. Yeah, the verdict, guys, is the light hash rate 1 and the light hash rate 2 arguments seem to be effective for LOLMINER. I'm just going to repeat myself again. I'm not blown away, but I will say this. They've made strides. Okay. So I know NVMiner were the first guys to kind of crack things open a little bit in terms of the light hash rate, cards, to, you know, unlock that 70%. And now we have GMiner and LOLMINER making strides. So, you know, time, it's only a matter of time until they get better and refine more, you know, power consumption and refine more of the hash rate with these cards. And who knows, maybe we'll even see 100% unlock and we'll, you know, be ripping 50 plus mega hash on Ethereum on these cards. One can only hope. But guys, I hope you learned something. I hope you got some value out of these videos. These light hash rate cards are definitely cool to test and to play with. I've had fun with them. We'll continue to document and see what comes around next. But with that said, if you like what you saw, please give a like and a thumbs up, and definitely subscribe because it keeps the channel flowing and going, and it's much appreciated, guys. And with all that being said, I hope you have a wonderful rest of the day, and we will see you on the next video. Take care.